Characteristics are already pretty good, in particular like the microprocessor, the J3455 from Intel is actually very powerful for media consumption and general usage. It's a quad core, so it is nice and responsive. Here we have the machine itself. Let me just quickly get it out of the box. Fantastic. So as you can see from the array of port, the two HDMI, USB, that's the power connector, LAN, microphone, a cable for which you can put it nice and secure, further USB, two Type 3 as well, Type 2 over there, power button, TF card, and a very interesting way to remove the lid is just by simply switching this, and then you can remove the lid over here, and you can attach an extra hard drive or SSD if you want. Let's see what else we have. Of course, set of instruction. Not that I will particularly look at those too much, but you know, it's good to have them. The machine comes pre-installed with Windows 10 already. I think it's the home edition. The little computer can also be attached behind the monitor. There is a VESA attachment there, and here is a bracket for which it can then be put directly onto the monitor. Sorry, that way. There we go. So this goes behind the monitor and then the computer onto it. And finally, in this box, we should have the adapter and good HDMI cable as well already. Great to have it. And the power adapter with the British connector as well. So this is to give you a quick indication of my current setup. I have a triple monitor system going through my main PC over there. Keyboard and mouse, of course, over here, and I would like to use this for both my mini PC and my main PC just by going through a switch. One of the key components is, of course, that KVM switch, which will allow me then to have the same peripherals for the main machine and a mini computer. One thing that I forgot while I was doing the unpacking, there are also quite a few screws inside for the VESA mount. Okay, getting close to testing. As you can see, everything has been connected neat and tidily. As I said, the only issue that I have at the moment is that for the main monitor, I don't have a connector. But I did attach, I don't know if I can show you, I did attach the top monitor there. And of course, I still have another HDMI 3. It is my fault. I should have checked it earlier. I will order anyway an adapter. As I said, it's not very expensive, and then I will attach the main monitor as well. So, possibly mission accomplished. There is the monitor. As you can hear, I mean, I'm right on the top of it. There is no noise whatsoever at the moment coming from the machine. I'll be quiet so you can hear it. So, yeah, the machine right now is totally silent. The main monitor, as soon as I get the adapter, I will put it onto the mini PC as well. But in the meantime, we can go through the configuration with the monitor up there. Well, I will try not to bore you with all the configuration. Windows, the first time that it's loaded, takes some time with regards to the updates, Cortana, all the setup, and everything else. But I will try to. There you go. There is Cortana talking as usual. Okay, guys, as you can see, I just went inside the Intel HD graphic control panel because, in my case, because I'm using a television, I had to resize a bit the monitor itself. Potentially, what we can do is open a YouTube video and take it from there. So just to show you quickly, guys, I have a few things open at the moment. I have an HDF footage through Netflix. I have a performance monitor system there. In the meantime, I am downloading several updates for Windows. So yeah, the machine is working absolutely fine. In all honesty, it is quite responsive. Even if it's a mini PC, is working very well. The processor, as I said before, it is a very good one. The CPU at the moment is, well, actually, it's working pretty well. About it's jumping between 50 and
80% with regards of everything that is running. Memory is perfectly sufficient for the need. I'm downloading an antivirus. I have several Google pages there. It is also downloading all the software updates and everything else in the background. So the machine is working flat out, and it has been working flat out for some time. But as you can see, it's not exactly thermal throttling. It's working at top speed with no problem. The memory seems to be also pretty good. You can see actually the CPU usage over there, over the 100%, because of course it's using the turbo boost option. So far it's working well. As I said, the only slight downfall, let me see if I can make you hear the noise fan. So there is a tiny bit of noise fan there, which is not exactly an issue. Just to test this mini computer, I've also installed a game. This is Asphalt 9. As you can see, it is graphically quite demanding. I'm not saying that this machine is a gaming machine. However, it's capable of playing certain games very, very well, and this is definitely one of them. Just to conclude, I really like the little mini PC. On the plus and minus, I have to say the design, I find it very, very good, with the very large array of ports, two HDMI, four USB, two of them are Type 3 as well, which is stunning. A TF card is also a very good point. The look is good. What I don't like is then the plastic. It feels a tiny bit cheap. It might not look, but it feels a bit cheap for some reason. And the other thing that I don't like is the fan. It is not that noisy, however, it's more noisy than it should be. I think potentially they could spend a bit more and put a quieter fan in it, but it's a minor thing. On the massively positive points though, for the price, it is incredibly powerful. I mean, you saw me playing some graphically demanding games and it's fine. Multitasking works very, very well as well. It is very frugal with regards to the amount of energy that is used. In my case, used with the switch over there, I can then go between one machine and the other nice and easily, so I managed to achieve exactly what I wanted to. It's stunning for any media consumption, for things like writing letters, emails, the day-to-day type of tasks that I mostly do. So personally, I'm very pleased with the purchase.